Coming in at 7 inches or about 18 centimetres, this is Cyberpunk 2077 V. If you have not seen the trailers for this game, oh my goodness, I'm so excited. We get a very nice piece of packaging here from McFarlane Toys. I love this. Not a toy. What is it then? A collectible? So this character's name is V, and we get some kind of graffiti inside, something of NCPD. NCPD Carbones, it's something to do with the game, obviously, but it's really not that detailed. There's not much going on inside the box, so not giving too much away. V is his name on the side, McFarlane Toys up there. He's got a window box all the way throughout. And on the back, we get a look at another figure that's available in the line. He's got several versions of him, and that is Johnny Silverhands, aka Keanu Reeves. There's one with guitar and one with a bag. There is also this dude's partner, which has just been put up for pre-order. We'll put some links for Cyberpunk figures below if you want to pick this up. This one has been selling really well and has sold out pretty fast, actually. The game, I think, is going to get to the point where the hype is going to be up there, and I suspect these figures will be pretty much in demand. CD Projekt Red, talented studio. There's a great documentary online if you want to check out more about them, which really covers this very interesting past about The Witcher, etc. There we go, some UPC should you need it, and don't stick it up your nose stuff. So packaging's very nice, very simple, but I do like that. It's kind of nice to display with the logo in the side of the box. And we get a couple of nice little features with it. First up, I should mention, comes with a very nice little pistol, as you can see there. So he's got three weapons. This smaller pistol here, got a bit of silver on it and a bit of black overall. Let me just get that light on that a little better. There we go, that's a little better. So some nice rugged kind of sculpting, little hint of silver at the very end there. It's nice, I do like it. So simple stuff, kind of difficult for him to store it because his hands are full with these two weapons. So, you know, you've got nowhere to put the weapon, which is a shame. I thought there might be a holster or somewhere we could put the gun, but no. Anyway, we get this bizarre, I guess it's a hologram of some kind in the game. Pink samurai sword. It's obviously some reference to part of the game which I've not yet picked up on. But there's a nice little touch of detail up at the top there. I don't know what it is. Little kind of rabbit-like piece or something. Pink rabbit? Oh, okay, what is this? But it's a very weird kind of design, but I'm assuming it's a kind of holographic-like style blade or something. But very plain, very weirdly done. It's I think it's designed to look like this, but it certainly does look like a 3D printed piece overall. We'll get onto his jacket in just a minute. But this weapon, oh my goodness gracious, check this thing out. So it's a black underneath the body. Then McFarlane, superb as they are at paint, have washed this across with a silver sexy wash across this to really pop out all the details of this weapon. That was one of the factors when I saw this weapon. I thought, yeah, I'm going to pick this up even just for that gun. It looks so good. So sweet. And he holds it pretty well. And just loads and loads of details on it. Reminds me of very James Cameron alien-esque-ish of some kind. I know it doesn't really look any like that, but just go with me. But some nice styles and design on it, I should say, as I kind of started there. But anyway, on with V. His jacket has some stunning little pieces of artwork on it. And again, if you watch the trailers, and there's plenty of them, and documentaries as I have, you'll see a lot of stuff going on. Samurai in his jacket, so again, hence the samurai sword. Lots of really nice cuts and folds and designs on that, down to the kind of ribbed jacket. 2077, but still bomber jackets are the thing. However, his is a little special. We'll show you that in just a minute. He's got this little patch on his arm there, a kind of semi-military-esque vibe something, and I do not know what that is. If you know, leave a note in the comments. Some cool little pieces here. Kind of reminds me of Wolfenstein 2. If people out there know what I mean, but the jacket is really pretty beautiful, and it does play a big part in the trailers and the game. What does that say? Crystal Jock on his jacket there. In the trailer, this piece at the back here is actually lit up. It's a blue kind of, it lights up his face, and it's pretty cool. So I've already seen some cosplay prototypes out there, and his face is designed to be modular. Again, if you've seen the trailer, you'll understand that people basically in 2077 put their faces together as cybernetic parts. Kind of like some women are doing on Instagram right now, and dudes. So some nice paint on there. They really capture the stubble fairly well. It's a transfer. And not too shabby a looking face. It's pretty like him, actually. I mean, it's not a photorealistic face, but for a hand-painted face, it's quite nice. And there's a nice shade going on in the hair, the way it's done there. So, yeah, pretty impressed. A little bit of red and rose in the cheeks, maybe a little bit too much at the bottom, but it adds a little bit of definition, such as his eyebrows and other pieces. So, not too shabby at all. Comes with a stand. Yay! Which is really pretty helpful, because he's a little lumpy on his feet. And there's not a great deal else to show you on the figure. It just goes down to these funky little trainers, sneakers, whatever, down the bottom. Kind of very Back to the Future-esque vibe going on. Peckles, obviously. And pretty plain pants slash trousers, etc., etc. So there we go. Pretty plain figure. Lots of cool articulation on him overall. So you can see head join there is on one of these little freaky weird pins. The neck is also... It seems to be on some kind of articulation in the neck too. So you get some limited range, but he's really not too restricted at all, so no major issues. The jacket is soft plastic and just sits over the body, so you've got some room to move around. And that houses in, as you can see, both a butterfly joint up at the top, which kind of moves in just a little bit, as you can see. Onto that swivel too. You've got a double joint at the elbow, looking very tasty indeed, and kind of not so nice wrists on these little ball joint peg pieces, but you know what? It's doing the job. It's not too shabby. He does have an upper ab crunch. You can see that there. It really doesn't do a great deal. It's just kind of limited, very much like that Batman figure. It's styled very low down rather than high up. We got a waist articulation there, which is a little bit stiff to move around. These jeans are very kind of hard to flex again, but it does move around. Legs have that kind of weird joint that these guys have, which is both a peg up at the top, but then a kind of swivel piece as well. It's kind of hard to... It's really a thigh swivel, but anyway, you get the point. It's kind of odd, but it works. It does work. Down two double joints at the knees, and down a boot cut on the top of his sneaker, and then toe articulation too. So he's really very well articulated. Pretty cool looking figure overall, I have to say. I think these guys look very well indeed. And even just standing it next to, and I know it's not in scale, but just to give you a rough idea, there he is next to a Marvel Legends figure, if it will stand next to him. There we go. Oh, come on. So, you know, about an inch shorter, 3/4 of an inch shorter than that. But yeah, they look pretty good. I am impressed with this line. I'm again holding reserve judgment till I get the game, because I think I'm going to just love the game so much that I'll want the figures. So expect to see more. Johnny Silverhands is on the way, but some nice shading, some nice paint, really standout weapons, great articulation, really. It's not too bad a figure at all. Check it out. Link in the description below. We'll see you for more reviews.